All right, another full hour of Olympics coverage coming up right now behind me. Son of a gun, darn if it hasn't started snowing again. Right now, we're going to get our first look at ski jumping in these Olympic Games. The ski jump in the Nordic combined from the 70-meter jump. Here's Keith Jackson, his expert, Jay Rand.
Intermittent snow and wind troublesome all day at Valopaljo for the Nordic combined jumping competition. The standings after two rounds, Mueller of West Germany leads, Mittenin, Finland second, Anderson of Norway third, and the Americans, Paddy, Hearn 12, and Kerry Lynch 20th. There's been one fall in the jumping so far. Drago Vidic, a Yugoslavian here, fell in the first round suffering a mild concussion and bruises. The weather was not the only factor in that fall. Both the first and second rounds were stopped and restarted by the jumping jury, each time jumpers going beyond the critical point into a dangerous landing area. The jury shortening the end run to slow them and reduce distance each time Americans suffered losses in points. Pat Ahern, for example, lost more than 8 points in the first round rejump alone. And now into the third round we go with a good one, Sergei Cherevyakov of the Soviet Union. He is in ninth spot after two jumps.
He's a tough jumper, and if he runs well, he could be in good contention for an overall victory. And it looked like he had a long jump there. He picked his knees up at the end, but he's going to have some good distance points.
He's liable to be the new leader. He jumped 88 meters, and the points, 104.8 for him. That gives him 210.3 total and puts him at the top of the scoreboard. Now this is Pat Ahern of Breckenridge, Colorado, in 12th place, and Pat surely must be thinking the sky is about to fall on him because he has had nothing but trouble all day. He lost heavily in points in both of the rejumps. He could have been leading this jumping competition after the first two rounds had they not been in the rejump situation. But right now, Pat Ahern needs the jump of his life to move back into contention.
It's going to be tough for Pat. Psychologically, after a good jump like that, it's just hard to do it again. He had a nice ride, good landing, but he's a little short.
81 meters, bad in style points, only 91.6, 195.1 his total. He'll be well back. So it's been a tough day for Pat Ahern of Breckenridge, Colorado.
And right there, it looked like he dropped down a little too low. Caused him to come up. He didn't get on the air quick enough. He lost a little airspeed and he was a little behind. He should have been over his skis more.
And it'll be a hard day for Pat Ahern to forget. You can't shrug it off. Thomas Muller now, West Germany, leader after two jumps. He needs a solid effort here to retake the lead from the Soviet jumper, Sergei Cherevyakov.
He's a strong jumper, and if he can combine his running skills with that, he could do well. And there's a nice jump. Long one.
87 meters, 1022, total points, 2091. He's in second place behind the Soviet jumper. Disappointed as he looks back up the mountain at the scoreboard, another look.
He really drove quickly into the air. The ski tips came up well, and he just rolled it over, floating down the hill, using the air currents, and goes into a nice steady landing.
So Muller is in second place as we turn next to Tom Sandberg of Norway in fifth spot. And this man had big profits from the second round rejumps. A lot of people rate him the man to beat, but he had to have the luck of the rejump to put him in the position that he's in right now. Tom Sandberg.
Timing looked good, and he's driving it way down. Beautiful landing. He's going to love that one.
Long jump, 88 meters. That will be worth 105.8, gives him 214.7 points, and he now takes the lead.
As he approaches the end run, you can see the forward compression and the snap at the knees. Powerful, smooth, and there he rolls it over. Aerodynamically, it's excellent, and a beautiful landing.
Tom Sandberg of Norway, now in the lead at 214.7. Next, we'll have a look at Kerry Lynch of the United States. And this is the man who also was burned in that second round rejump decision. There were only four jumpers to go when the jury stopped them. So instead of Kerry Lynch, who was in the blocks ready to go, instead of letting him be the first man in the rejump, the jury restarted from the top of the order, which is exactly opposite of what they did in the first round rejump. So Lynch had to come down. He waited for more than a half an hour before he could go back up the tower and get his jump. He is now in 21st place as he goes for his third jump of the day.
Psychologically, this is going to be very difficult for Carey after waiting all that time. It looked like he brought his chest up on the takeoff, and he did have a bit of a problem controlling his skis.
79 meters, but bad on style points. 85.9 points. Total for Carey Lynch, 181.8, and that will drop him farther back in the rankings. So there are your final results of the Nordic combined jumping. They've got 1,500-meter cross-country coming up. Here's Jay Rand with Carey Lynch.
Carey, it's been kind of a tough day. You must be very disappointed with your jumping.
Yeah, well, technically, I thought I was doing things right. As you can see, you know, seems like every time we get a good rhythm going or something like that, somebody would exceed the critical point and have to start the round over. Which great gave inspiration for guys like, Tom Sandberg and, you know, people like that that weren't jumping so good at the beginning. They liked it and they kept going. But other people, you know, like myself, I got cut off the first time. I had a couple guys before me, and in the next round, I had one guy that started before me exceeded the critical point, and it just blows your concentration. We had to walk down, get back into it, and it was one of those things you have to just keep trying to work for. But you know, it's really that's the rules, and it's not fair. But you know, the wind. This is a wind hill. We had crazy wind today. You know, the guy that went 92 meters went back up and went 72, and he's a great jumper. He told me he had about the same takeoff as when he went 92. He just got hit from the side, and when you do that, you either fall on your side or you have to come down. So, you know, just a crazy day.
I'm kind of surprised. I thought Carey Lynch might even be angrier than that. Now let's turn to Jim Page, the U.S. Nordic Program Director.
Jim, it appears that a jury decision has affected the entire outcome of the jumping today.
Yeah, Jay, I'm so frustrated. I guess I'm halfway between anger and tears. I hate to see politics enter into sport, but it obviously did today. I don't think that the jury, which is composed of five members, made a conscious decision to take a medal away from the Americans, but in effect, that's what they did. And I think what happened is they saw an opportunity, the people on the jury, to help their own country after some of their athletes had a bad jump. It's real terrible.
Bit of controversy up there on the hill. Now remember, that was the Nordic combined jumping. Tomorrow, they ski 15 kilometers cross country. At the same time, the specialist ski jumpers will take over that hill. We'll see more ski jumping, the 70 meter special ski jumpers. So that's the story for this moment. We're gonna have a lot more coming up on the rest of this night's program.